so I think what drew me to medicine is that I have in my family, like many other people, have experienced cancer. My grandmother had endometrial cancer, my mother had breast cancer, and their experience in Puerto Rico, not really able to connect with doctors, where doctors tell you what to do and this is what's gonna happen. And they got these treatments, but they didn't understand them. I wanted to change that. So I'm the first college grad in my family, and I don't have any doctors in my family. So when I applied to medical school, I feel like it was kind of like a miracle that it happened. I went to a very good program. I went to Columbia and I went to Penn with scholarships. And I found great mentors who were not Hispanics, but they saw something that they wanted to promote. That's one of the most rewarding parts of my day job, that I have patients that immediately when they see me, they can connect because we can speak the language. But not only is it not a language issue, it's really understanding the cultural nuances, like understanding that their family is a big part of their healthcare decision group. So like you have to involve them and be respectful of their family. So being able to connect with them at that level makes them feel that you took one of these barriers out, that you they don't have to be overwhelmed about having that doctor connect with them.
Well, I think I'm only the first or second Latino NCI Cancer Center director in the United States. You know, so it's a neat connection with that community. I had the chance this year to testify before Congress, you know, regarding changes in FDA regulations and legislation regarding diversity in clinical trials. You know, as I was able to share when the First Lady came to visit our cancer center, that, you know, diversity on clinical trials in our care, it's both about social justice, because, you know, we want everyone in our society to be able to benefit from the advances that we have. But secondly, it's also good science. You know, as we evaluate a treatment, whatever that is, that could be yoga, that could be a drug, that could be stem cell transplant. But we want to know about whether it is safe and whether it's effective. We wouldn't know, is it effective in Asia, in Cuba, in Africa? Or might we have worse side effects? Might we have no side effects? So the diversity is powerful.
So I think this space and this time where Latinos are coming together to support each other and recognize each other is kind of letting other younger Latinos feel like this is a field where they can make a career, and they can be happy, and they can make a difference. You know, if you have a dream, you should pursue it. And oncology can be a very intense field, but it's a very rewarding field, and we need you.
Myself, I lost my father to lung cancer. He died at 62, and now he passed away now 16 years ago. You know, and I think about it really in terms of all those things that he missed because of the disease that he had. He won't see my sister get married this upcoming February. He didn't see my brother get married 2 years ago. He won't meet their children. He's not seen my children grow up into adults. You know, it is a loss that can't be replaced. The problem with cancer is that it's a thief. It steals from us, you know, length of life and quality of life, either from us, the patients we love, family members. So the power not only to be able to care, but to really try to make a difference. What does that mean? People live longer, they live better. You know, deeply rewarding, deeply grateful to have that opportunity.